I want to spend a few minutes here discussing the research matrix, and you'll see that I have two examples that I'd like to go over. Depending on what kind of essay or text or paper that you need to write, you might consider one or the other as to which would be more appropriate. So the first example would be more representative for a maybe a five paragraph essay, and you'll notice here under ideas you'll have an introduction and then topic sentence one, topic sentence two, topic sentence three. So if we're looking at a five paragraph essay, you might consider each of these topic sentences as beginning each of the body paragraphs. So if in a five paragraph essay, again, you're going to have three body paragraphs, and you might have some references that you include in the introduction. So it's always a good idea to make sure that you're working with your teacher to make sure that you have met the expectations as to how many references or citations you need to include. I'll give you some suggestions or tips as to what I would consider, but again, it's always best to clarify this from the beginning with your teacher so that you're meeting his or her expectations. So if you look at the topic sentence here, you'll notice in row three we have reference one, reference two, reference three, and so on. In this space, I would include the author and the year, author or authors and the year. And in this cell, for example, in the introduction, if you have a citation that you want to include in that first paragraph, I would include the claim or even the direct quote along with the page number. The key is to include enough information in this matrix so that you can easily find or go back to that source. And you might want to consider including the direct quote in each of these cells just so that you see exactly what the main claim is. You will need to decide whether or not you want to paraphrase or include the direct quote, but just because you include the direct quote here doesn't necessarily mean you include the direct quote in your actual paper. So you can always paraphrase at any point. But whatever seems to be, whatever works for you is what I would do. But again, you can always, you don't want to paraphrase too much where you lose the main idea of the claim. And so in this matrix, again, if you include the direct quote, it might be easier. Do remember that it's recommended not to include more than 15% of your text as a direct quote. So you want to use direct quotes at a very minimum, only when the author says something very very important and maybe in an interesting way that you want to capture. So I think in most cases you'll want to paraphrase. So in each of these cells you will include the claim and along with the page number, and so this will be, in terms of a five paragraph essay, this will be by paragraph. So in the first paragraph, let's say you have two to three references, you will include those claims under each of these references. And you'll do the same for each of the topic sentences or the main ideas. Notice here at the bottom, I have main idea here. It's the same idea. Your main idea or your topic sentence will be captured here. And again, I would just list it as a topic sentence, thinking in terms of a five paragraph essay. In the second example, this would be more for a longer paper. So thinking in terms of maybe a thesis seminar where you might have sections, you can include the main idea and replace the word section one with the phrase, the word or phrase that represents that main idea. So you're going to have basically main ideas and sub ideas or subtopics, and so you can think of these main ideas here as subtopics to this overall idea. Okay, so here you can replace main idea as you can replace topic sentence with the word or phrase that represents that idea, and you could almost look at this side of the matrix as almost an outline as well as here. Okay, so here you have section one, you can replace this with the main idea, and then these main ideas here will be the ideas that are represented in each of the body paragraphs. My recommendation would be to take this information to the paragraph level so that when you're filling out your references and your claims for each of these cells, again, you're at the paragraph level so that you have an idea about how many sources you're going to cite and how those sources compare and contrast. When you're including the claims here, you are essentially comparing and contrasting. Either authors are going to essentially say similar things or say the exact same thing, or they're going to differ in some way. So really the idea with this matrix is to help facilitate how you synthesize information, how you basically compare and contrast information or sites or sources and in terms of a particular idea. All right, so as you go through and fill out this matrix, this will be, I think, a tool to help you when you begin drafting your paragraphs and your essay. You can use this to easily go back to your source. So I hope this helps. This is two general examples of how you can complete this research matrix, regardless if you're writing a five-paragraph essay or writing a more involved essay in terms of maybe thesis seminar where you're writing a 5,000 to 6,000 word essay or thesis. And so feel free to use this and adapt it to your needs, but I think this is a good way to get started when you begin synthesizing the literature.